Today in the episode, Mad Lab. We rate your crafts in Psycho Pete's. Voice of the Wasteland, where we read your messages and choose the craft of the episode. And we begin with Workshop, the Dragon King gun for cunning tacticians. The way of the Wastes is pretty simple. The more weapons there are, the better. With gargantuan kaijus all over the place, though, it's pretty easy to overlook their little brother called Yongwan, after the Dragon King from the previous era. Why do we call it the kaiju's little brother? There are several reasons for that. First of all, they are clearly related and come from the same family of the one-gun-only variety. Yongwan requires 9 energy. There's literally no way to run 2 of them. Secondly, it's big. Not as big as kaiju, true, but still very chunky. Thirdly, it hits like a truck, but works in a peculiar fashion. When you fire it, the Yongwan shoots 5 grenades that explode on contact with the enemy, or just after a short time. Furthermore, its damage is increased by 15% for each point of energy spent on hardware, meaning that the Yongwan can be easily turned into a real beast damage-wise, especially if you're also using the Harpy. Now that we know how it works, let's test it out in combat. We'll take a reliable design, you can find it in the exhibition by searching for TG2, and update it a bit. Why this design in particular? Most importantly, it allows us to mount the gun at an angle, which is very beneficial to us as Syndicate engineers clearly went all in on damage and didn't care much about proper elevation angles. Moreover, this car has lots of room for additional modules, and is already equipped with a cabin we need. Neat! In the end, we get a pretty fast vehicle that can take a lot of punishment, and performs really well at close range or in ambushes, but comes with a gun that won't be as effective on big sprawling maps. Basically, the bigger the distance to the enemy, the harder it is to hit it with Yongwan grenades. They're slow. It's not easy to land them, even at mid-range. Not to mention that our Dragon King isn't sturdy enough to take shots out in the open. At the same time, keep in mind that grenades don't explode right away, and more importantly, bounce off walls and allies. Yep, that's right. If you're good at it, the Yongwan allows you to destroy your opponents in a lot of spectacular and nigh impossible ways. And yeah, the damage output is insane, especially if the target eats the full volley. Be careful. The Yongwan wasn't built to be utilized recklessly. Punish your opponent's mistakes. Hit them where it hurts. If they're also playing safe and hiding behind cover, use your indirect fire capability and turn the terrain against them. You can't hide from the wrath of the Dragon King. And now, a short commercial break.
Only in the East Quarter, a mammoth gun with a pickle, a ravager on a stick, and all sort of other delicacies. We guarantee there are at least some organics in every meal.
Survivors are tenacious, quick-thinking, and generally fearless. That's just expected by this point. What surprises us time and time again, though, is how good survivors are at coming up with ideas and building stuff. To showcase your talent, and maybe even to prove it to someone, today we're going to wreck some red vehicles on cars we took directly from the exhibition. And to make it all official and easy to understand, we'll be rating your crafts using the most universal and widely accepted unit of measurement, the Psycho Pete Scale. The first car that caught our eye is this two-wheel drifting beauty called Firebird, made by Master Pandamania, a proper vehicle for a true Knight Rider. Yeah, it's not jet black, but it's still very, very good, especially if you're into lighting the world on fire with exploding barrels. At the same time, it's pretty fragile. No molecular bonded shell here, so don't use it to engage enemies head-on. Please. 6 Psycho Pete's out of 10. What do we have here? A tank? A drone? Nope, it's a drone carrier called Mama i Detya, or Mother and Children in Russian, which was made to look like a drone, Yeah, we covered a vehicle with a similar concept before, but this model, created by Flexus, has a much tighter layout and uses a recently added chassis, which is nice. As you know, drones aren't the most quick-witted adversaries, but this car is so well-built that it'll certainly surprise both the enemy, with its damage output, and your teammates, with its killer looks. Beauty is power, indeed. 7 Psypeats out of 10. So many pedestrians, so little time. Apparently, when designing this craft, Master El Quasimoda took these holy words to heart. The name of the car? Carmageddon. Obviously. At first glance, though, it doesn't look that menacing. Weapons have barely any armor, it's all tracks, and the cabin is vulnerable to enemy fire. Don't rush to conclusions, friends. Try it out, and you'll find that this car doesn't just perform well, it can dunk on almost anyone. The only big flaw we see, and it's a recurring theme today, is that Carmageddon is pretty fragile. So keep that in mind. 8 Psypeats out of 10. The last battle car on our list today is Gan Omega, a glorious all-terrain vehicle that has a strong futuristic vibe. Nice flowing lines, a pretty profile, a cool color scheme, tasteful decals, and lots of firepower. What else do you need? Obviously, this is a car that was built to be pretty first and foremost, and not necessarily to fight other survivors in the irradiated dunes of a dying world. But we still couldn't help falling in love with it. Do you know why? This pretty car hits so hard that you'd have to be completely mad to go against it in close range. It'd be even better if those grenade launchers could survive a few more hits. But, well, it's not the car's fault that we're driving it in a way that would make Psycho Pete giggle in delight. Well, bloody done. 9 Psypeats out of 10. Do you want to see one of your creations featured in the garage? Submit your designs to the exhibition. Who knows? Maybe Odegon will give it a try. The first message was sent by Carbody.
Could you guys maybe add a special decor item when you get a kill? It makes a little white chalk mark on the item, and you can reset the amount of chalk marks anytime?
Sounds like a really cool idea. Not sure how we can approach it, but we love the way it sounds. Thanks for suggesting it. Then we have this question by John O'Quinn. He asks,
will we have expanded space to add props and decors to place around our garages? Would love to have more building space.
Hi, it is possible we're discussing it, but definitely not soon. Dangerously Incompetent Plays Crossout writes,
have the devs even considered Leviathan Racing?
Ha! We like the way you think, but that would just be all about the smallest Leviathan winning 100% of the time. So we're probably not gonna do anything like that. Probably. Jesse Rexroad says,
more pyrotechnics! Fireworks, flares, and flame-spitting exhaust pipes are great! Whirling wheels on fire! Not a hologram effect or something that recharges, but flames on, baby!
Odegon approves of this message. And now the traditional last segment of the show, the Craft of the Week. We've shown you quite a lot of cool user-made cars in the episode, though. So instead, we invite you to join us on a ride to the mysterious tribal temple made by Sosuke Aizen. What can we say? It's amazing what you guys can do with basic blocks and our editor. Certainly didn't expect tribal aesthetics to mix this well with Eastern Asia vibes, but here we are, visiting a well-built space temple. A perfect place for conducting forbidden rituals, unraveling the bot curse, summoning leviathans, you know, the usual Monday stuff. Great job, thank you. And if after a visit to the temple you find yourself itching for some simpler pleasures that can be measured in Psypeats, go to the map called Junkyard, created by Corge13. Not gonna spoil it, you'll see it yourselves. That's it for today. Tell us what you think in the comments below, ask us questions, and if we somehow stop trying to get a better score on the Junkyard, we'll return with some new crazy content in a couple of weeks. If you like what we're doing, consider subscribing, leave a like, and good luck!